There's been so many times when the fog's rolled in and I think, well, that's gonna make it cold down here. And the steam comes up through the grates and the sidewalk and all the hard edges disappear and it's not nearly so cold as you might think it would be. It's like walking in a pillowcase or an opium dream. I come in with the fog and go out with the trash and can't account for a thing in between. If you're looking for Madonna, you quickly find that that's a myth. She's not the kind of girl that used to live next door, and she's not the kind you'd want to have rough sex with. She's not the kind of girl that married dear old dad, and she's certainly not the kind to dig your lip. Things have gotten so self-service down here, you might have to be your own guide, hotelier, and pimp. I've followed a woman out of a liquor store and down the street on back to her hotel, and she'll say, but I'm not even working yet. Ask me for the time, and she'll say, what the hell. She might have a waist like a baby child. She might be pregnant, or what's even worse is her eyes might be heavy dim and lidded like the back window of a hearse. My eyes have been murdered, 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 murdered. And every time I've been hustled, rolled a con, the last thing I remember was a cocksucking blonde. Hey, loving like a cocksucking blonde. Hey, loving like a cocksucking blonde. I've paid with drugs, things I didn't know what they were, other things that I've actually used, and what with pharmaceutical inquiries and negotiations, as you can imagine, things get pretty confused. I've paid with things I've gotten places after they were closed, and things that I've gotten from my friends after they'd become indisposed. I paid with credit cards two at a time. I paid with jewelry when I was in my prime. And I paid with whiskey, bottled in bond, and that was just fine with a cocksucking blonde. Hey, nothing like a cocksucking blonde. Hey, nothing like a cocksucking. I've come to outside the 181, the old 181 club where I'd been thrown out on my heel. And a child standing over me saying, how do you feel? I said, I'm too ashamed to tell you how I feel. I've come to on a ball court out by Golden Gate Avenue, the needle damn near sticking up my ass, and one of my front teeth in my top pocket, and I don't know how that came to pass. And the hotel rooms, oh God, the worst time was most recently. I was so frightened when they came through the door, I shouted, police officers did not do this to me. Police officers did not do this to me. I've thought of welfare two or three times, and the only thing that's ever held me back was the thought that I might wind up on Broadway somewhere with no place to come but a brown paper sack. So I've held on to shit jobs, and it's hurt me, and I got to where I can dish it out all right. There ain't nothing I like better than to get it all together down at Leavenworth and Eddie on a Saturday night. And I wave my wallet like a magic wand, and presto, here come a cocksucking blonde. And ain't nothing like it. Ain't nothing. When you're walking with a cocksucking blonde, your feet barely touch the ground. When you're talking with a cocksucking blonde, your mouth barely make a sound. I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde at Spivvy's underneath the San Juan. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde all night at Denny's out at Ceremony Mall. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde in a vacant lot beside the Sound of Music. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde upstairs at the El Rio. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde in the mezzanine at Rock City. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde in the stairs above the Stockton Tunnel. And I've set and suffered with a cocksucking blonde outside the four-faced Buddhist temple.